want to move on to the issue with Congresswoman Ilhan Omar and President Trump's tweet that Nancy Pelosi and the Congresswoman herself say has upped the amount of death threats that the Congresswoman is getting. They've seen a spike in the threats against her, and so the Capitol Police, et cetera, are having to expend extra resources to protect her. Does the president know that he's putting her in danger?
Well, I don't think it's the president who's putting her in danger. I think it's her ill-thought-out words that she used to describe the greatest terror attack on the history of United States soil, that which killed nearly 3,000 Americans. The fact that those are her words, that's what's putting making the threats. But make no mistake, no congressperson, no American should be threatened, and no one is inciting violence. I think what they're doing is showing outrage toward words that should have been better thought out.
Well, yeah, I mean, she's saying that it's since the president's tweet that what the Nancy Pelosi and the congresswoman, and obviously the records could show this, that the amount of death threats and the calls coming in have spiked since the president's tweet. And so let's just give them the benefit of the doubt and say that that's true. Is the president considering taking down that tweet?
Well, I'm not aware of the president planning to take down that tweet, but I think it's also important that the American people realize that these are the words that are being spoken by leaders of the Democrat Party. In many cases, you've got Democratic leaders and leading presidential candidates coming out and defending those words. Yeah. And so many people are offended by that because, I mean, this was an attack that killed nearly 3,000 people.
Yeah.
And to describe it as somebody who did something is just disrespectful.
Oh, sure. And you've heard people say that they thought that it was anything from inartful to offensive to hurtful. But I'm just talking about in terms of the threats themselves. Since you're saying that nobody should have their lives threatened, regardless of what words they choose, should the president take down that tweet?
I'm not going to tell the president what he should or should not do with his Twitter account, but I can tell you that I think it's absolutely appropriate when you have an elected official, someone who is standing as a member of Congress saying things, that you call out those things when they are inappropriate or offensive. We've seen the Democrat Party struggle with Representative Omar before on her anti-Semitic tropes, and now with these comments, it's something that the Democrats have failed to hold her accountable for. And while no member of Congress should be threatened, and no one is inciting that or encouraging it, but it is the appropriate action for elected officials to stand up, call out those comments, and ask that them be taken
understood.
Down.
Understood. And you do hear various pundits and various Democrats saying that, but in terms of you saying that nobody should incite violence, let's say the president didn't mean to incite violence, we'll obviously give him that benefit of the doubt, but his tweet is doing so. Would you like to see him take that down?
I'm not gonna get ahead of what the president may or may not do, but we have seen many people rightly express their outrage. You had the cover of the New York Post the other day before that tweet came out.
Yes.
Many people are expressing that outrage.
Yes.
And while I wouldn't hold the New York Post accountable for how a headline might be viewed, I'm not gonna hold the president's Twitter account to that either. Ultimately, what Congresswoman Omar needs to do is retract those statements and call the Islamic radical terrorists who did this terrible deed out for what they did.
Mark Lauder, we appreciate your perspective. Thank you very much.
Good to see you.